to better use Simone Claridge here. And this is part two of the series to go a little bit more into energetics and how this universe energetically has been created and how our soul actually came into existence. We want to go away from understanding us as a physical body, that's it. Because on the physical body, we are kind of victimized to, well, I'm built like this, I can't do anything. Let's open up to the possibility there is more and join in the concept of creation in the Taoist tradition. So in that system, as well as in other religious systems, the belief is that we came from one source, and over our lifetime we gather experiences and we go back and resolve back into source. So that can be translated, the Tao, as the way, according to those ancient esoteric traditions, is that all energetic vibrations and light is simply a part of the Tao, of source, of divine source, of divine presence, however you want to say it. And that source is therefore imprinted in every single part of our being, in everything that exists in the universe. In a scientific approach, we would say we are holographic. So what does it mean? As an example, if you pour blood for checking the biomarkers in your body and wanting to know how your health is, then you only need a tiny amount of blood. You don't need the whole blood in order to determine what's going on in your blood. So it's saying that everything that is contained in that small amount is representative for the whole. Whenever anything changes in a part of it, everything changes in the whole. So we have source pouring into an infinite space, always and continuously expanding. And whatever happens in that space has information of the divine, of Tao. So in that Taoist concept, they believe that before you have been perceived, created, as physical form, you have been part of that, an integrated part of the Tao. So at this point we have been with the divine, we have been divine and absolutely formless and undifferentiated. At conception we actually become less conscious and less aware of our power, and the whole idea is to find your way back while on this planet. You also have determined the experiences you want to make for this lifetime. That is what the ancient Chinese tradition have been believing in. In this concept, the source is called the Tao, and the big mind, the universal mind, contained in Wu Ji, what is this called here? So that would be God. And Wu Ji would be the space, and we call this the big void in those traditions. So this may help to translate that a little bit easier. And then the spirit part, which is usually those words are used in that tradition, would be called Shen in the ancient tradition. And then we have Qi, which is not quite accurate translated with energy, because the ancient tradition believed that the Qi was actually the pure information with the Qi, together. So we cannot simply translate this energy, but it's okay at this point. In this tradition, it is called Di Jing. That would be similar to matter in our tradition. When we see the Tao as an always expanding circle, so that's why I don't place a whole line into it. It contains everything because it's always continuously expanding. And energy is holding the opportunity for matter to appear. Divine is imprinting itself on energetic fields which direct forms and shapes in the small part. This is an ongoing transformational process. So transformation happens in more energetic field area. When forms are created, it's definitely not so easy to change them on that level. But when you change on transform the information, whatever has been given into that field, when you change that information, it's possible to change the matter. Suppose that would be a tumor. What, you know, it's a mass of dead cells, and definitely they have an information of death. So you would need to find the way how it has been created in the first place, what for information contain to hold that energetic field. And when the energetic field begins to change by your ability, when someone has a really high energetic field holding truth, then it is easily possible to influence without any saying, without any teaching, without any demonstration. In this way also, because we are in the energetic realms, not bound to space, it is possible that someone can sit on the other side of the planet, if you want to say, and you still are able to influence that person. Just pick up a phone, call someone, and give them the news. You know you have made an impact on this person, right? So it's really important to become more acquaintance to that interchangeable level and knowing where you are. Be alert. What dimension are you influencing? How does it affect the other dimensions? The medicine works with chemistry and surgery, mainly with the attempt to make changes to chemical reactions. It can work for short term in especially acute life-threatening situation in order to keep the body alive, but it does not work well for over long periods of time. For so-called chronic conditions, which often are medicated for long periods of time. We are multidimensional energetic beings, so everyone will respond to a medication to change in chemistry on all other levels as well, with the attempt now to balance this new situation. There's new chemistry coming in with new information. So the spiritual level, the vital level, the mental level, the emotional level will respond first before physical changes occur. And so the physical body will have a change, and that is then happening often over a longer period of time. Recently, I listened to an interview from the Dr. Pop Institute. His son was talking about biophotons and consciousness. Unfortunately, it's only in German, but I do understand it. And now imagine one cell of your body. In one cell, count from 21, 22, 1 second. There are 100,000 chemical reactions happening while counting from 21, 22. It's not even possible to wrap your mind around how this all would be controlled. So now we are not just one cell. We have, I mean, this body is built of trillions of cells. So this is a number we cannot even, I mean, digest in a sense. So what is able to bring this order, this information to function? And he comes up for, of course, light. And there is light that is creating everything, and also within you, that is of immense power. You could say it's divine power, because those are all these words that don't have a contrary to it. Love is love. The words that describe the oneness the best are the words that don't have an opposite. So when I'm saying love or divine power, there is no opposite to it, and it contains everything in it. So when I say light, that also that word, it has no, it's not the opposite of darkness. When I talk about this light, that's divine light. So I clarify on that, it's divine, God-like light. So every cell is producing and doing it by themselves, because they also have their own consciousness. Now imagine that all the cells are coming together, building groups of organs then, and systems, creating this whole body here. And I mean, every cell needs to have somehow a direction, and needs to be organized and follow the order of the universe and divine order. So as more as we are understanding where we came from, we also are becoming more acquainted that nature is that what we need to observe, the universe. So, and the easiest is to learn how we are within living heavens, sky, and on the planet. We are the extension between those two realms. So we need to listen. We need to listen from both sides. As the extension between heavens and earth, well, we have actually a function of antenna kind information, gathering information, letting go. And we are like from a big flame, we are small flames from the big flame. In ancient tradition, it was more seen as the luminous fire. And we are a spark of that luminous fire. So we are descending, as you find also in other tradition, descending through a kind of a veil. That veil is more translated in type of forgetting where we came from. So we have to move through that veil in order to become heavy enough to have a part that is able to live on that dimension here. So it becomes heavy enough, but there's another part before it goes through that veil that stays light enough to be right there behind the veil. You cannot lose it. It is a part. It is just to make experiences on this planet and sense parts of the part. So we are Tao, we are God, creation, particles. And from that particle, that you as a particle has to keep a part that is light enough above that veil, and a part below that veil, so you become heavy enough, so there is a possibility for you to be create a personality, and then become spirit part, become energetic part, and become Jing part or matter part. You are a multidimensional being that exists to make experiences. And record that actually back. Each part will bring something different back. There is nothing wrong on nobody. It's just experiencing things that was meant to be experienced. As humans, unfortunately, we try to understand with our intellectual mind, which is a tool. And I think that this society has unfortunately not supported intuition. It is not trained. It is not practiced. We are more valued by intellectual understanding and whatever degree we have. So I hope that helps you a little bit here, and Simone Claridge says goodbye. See you the next time. Bye-bye.